It's time to all rise for musical royalty and the 1976 track that Freddie Mercury thought was his best.
Somebody to Love had so many sides to it. It's got the whole gospel thing, but it's a kind of rock and roll song as well.
Certainly it was Freddie's favourite song of all the songs he composed.
Somebody. It is just one of the greatest songs of all time.
To find somebody to love, we need to head back to the mid-70s and a band of brainy rock revolutionaries with meticulous attention to detail.
I mean, each song that we do has a different sort of meaning to it. So, I mean, you know, it is rock and roll as a sort of label, but within that, I mean, each song is in a different sort of category, really.
Queen's work ethic was tremendous. Freddie Mercury's mantra was always, do it with quality and style, dear. But there was always this relentless pressure to come up with something new, something big, something better.
I see a little silhouette of a man.
Scaramouche, Scaramouche, will you do the bandango?
Thunderbolt and lightning, very, very frightening.
And that pressure went up a notch in 1975 with the release of their biggest ever seller, Bohemian Rhapsody.
I'm just a poor boy, nobody loves me.
Queen was such a technically proficient band. The prowess on just somehow coming up with a million bismillahs.
Bismillah, no, we will not let you go.
Let him go!
Bismillah, we will not let you go.
Bohemian Rhapsody set Queen apart as a band who could make harmonies sound like no other band could make harmonies.
The big question was, how do you follow that? Freddie's answer was another epic, taken from the highly anticipated Day at the Races album that followed Bohemian Rhapsody's Night at the Opera.
Somebody to Love, I think, was classic Freddie songwriting, and he always claimed that as a piece of pure songwriting, it's better than Bohemian Rhapsody.
Anybody?
This is Freddie. Brian May and Roger Taylor.
Somebody to love.
All in the studio with their cans on, in real time, doing these harmonized vocals.
Each morning I get out my dial, can barely stand on my feet.
Take a look, take yourself in the mirror.
They would sing all together. They described it as the sausage factory. Right, we'll do this one, let's knock that one out. Go in, let's do overdub one, two, three, whatever.
The end of those sessions, they were so exhausted, they could barely pick themselves up off the floor. Freddie, with his abundance of energy, was always urging them, just a few more, dear, just a few more.
I work, he works hard.
Every day of my life, I work till I ache my bones.
The difference was that in Somebody to Love, you have a gospel influence. And that was very much down to Freddie's passion for Aretha Franklin.
While all members of Queen contributed to the songwriting process, Somebody to Love was very much a Freddie composition.
Freddie was a gifted songwriter. He wrote songs very rapidly. They were sparks of inspiration, ingenuity.
And if he was looking for an idea, a chord, key, something, just... And suddenly it would come and he'd go, that's it, dear.
And he would never explain the songs either. You'd ask him sometimes, you know, does it mean this or that? And he'd say, well, it's like poetry, darling. You know, if you see it, it's there.
He was able to do opera. He was able to do glam, pop, rock. He could do it all. But what he always seemed to struggle to do was just write a straight song from the heart.
I work, he works hard.
Every day of my life, I work till I...
if you look at the lyrics to Somebody to Love, I think we're actually getting a little glimpse into the true Freddie Mercury, somebody who really is looking for someone to love genuinely and deeply.
I've thought about this song a lot down the years, and I think it was rather deeper than that. I think Freddie was trying to find a way of loving himself, and the somebody to love was really him. That was my reading of the song.
It satisfied him hugely to write that song. And it's strange that he never wrote anything like that afterwards, because in a lot of ways, it's the perfect song.
After Freddie's death, aged just 45 in 1991, a tribute concert for AIDS awareness was held at a sold-out Wembley Stadium.
So many artists performed with Queen. Axl Rose, Elton John, Liza Minnelli came out. But the most memorable performance of the night was George Michael singing Somebody to Love.
I worked hard, it was hard, every day of my life. I worked to like my bones, every day.
At the end of the day,
I take home my heart and pay all on my own.
I think initially the fear when you heard he was going to do it was that he wouldn't be able to do it justice. It was a different sensibility. In fact, George got straight to the heart of it. This was a soul classic. That was the moment where the real humanity of the song became much more apparent to a broader audience.
The 72,000-strong crowd were wowed by George Michael's stunning performance, and a live recording of the song took it to the top of the charts, one place higher than Queen's original in 1976.
George Michael, just in that one song, he nailed it. The same way Queen stole Live Aid, George Michael stole that show. That was a true tribute to Freddie.